So what's going on guys, it's JM, it's Speedbox here. Make sure you guys subscribe to my channel before you click on to any of my videos. Also comment below in the comment section if you guys have any opinions on what I'm saying in any of my videos. Like always, it is appreciated if you guys could drop me a quick sub or two on my channel and follow my Twitter at Speedboxing. So Cafe Duvar, the promoter of former unified light heavyweight champion of the world Sergey Kovalev, says that her promotional team main event were planning to sue unified light heavyweight champion Andre Ward's Team Roc Nation if Andre Ward didn't honour the rematch clause in the contract from the first fight, and if he didn't give Sergey Kovalev the rematch. Andre Ward defeated Sergey Kovalev by unanimous decision last November in a very controversial fight. A lot of people had Kovalev winning that fight, some people had Ward winning the fight, and in the contract from the first fight, if Sergey Kovalev lost to Ward, he would have got an immediate rematch. And to quote Cafe Duvar here, she says, "They just wouldn't talk to us for 3 months. Once they finally talked to us, it took about a week and a half, and we already had a deal in place. They just wanted to modify it before giving it to Andre. We had the rematch clause for the first contract. He promised us a rematch. He was going to get sued if he didn't go through with it. He was also going to get sued if he decided to retire. Andre wouldn't sign the contract for 3 weeks." And then when asked if she believed that Andre Ward was scared of Sergey Kovalev and he didn't want the rematch, Cafe Duvar says here, "To be fair, Andre Ward, I think he wants to fight. I really don't think that he doesn't. I don't understand why he does things the way he does. I think he wanted more and more money, and whatever else he was trying to get out of his promoters, I think it was more between him and his promoters." So Cafe Duvar here believes that Andre Ward does want to fight Sergey Kovalev, and he's just trying to get more money out of it. And you can understand Andre Ward doing that, because he is the champion now, but I don't understand why it took him so long to honour the rematch, because he should know that he had to give Sergey Kovalev the rematch. So hopefully it's just a thing between him and his promoters over money, but I think Andre Ward knew he had to give Sergey Kovalev this rematch no matter what. I think if he would have won the fight more clearly against Sergey Kovalev, say like he dominated Kovalev, then I think he could have put the fight off or waited it out a little bit longer, just because the first fight was so controversial, people just demanding it straight away. When's the rematch? When's the Ward-Kovalev rematch? Because we feel like Sergey Kovalev got done out of his titles and that he won the fight. And Sergey Kovalev obviously had a rematch in his clause. He was the defending champion in the fight. Andre Ward was a voluntary defence. It's not like Andre Ward was a mandatory for any of his titles. This was a voluntary by Sergey Kovalev. He didn't have to take the fight against Andre Ward. He decided to. He said, "You know what? Andre Ward thinks he's the best. I'll fight him." And then he lost the fight on the scorecards. Me personally, I had Andre Ward by about a round or two. I understand if people had Sergey Kovalev by a round or two. But all these people saying that Sergey Kovalev got robbed and he won the fight by about 5, 6, 7 rounds, then people can just fuck off, in my opinion, because that's just a load of shit. Like, I don't know what fight they're watching. They're watching another fight, because then that fight, I don't see Sergey Kovalev winning 5 or 6 rounds. I just don't see it. But this fight's on now on June 17th at the Mandalay Bay in Las Vegas, and I'm really looking forward to this fight. And I think whoever wins this fight, it will define the legacy. I think if Andre Ward beat Sergey Kovalev in this fight more convincingly than the first time, then I think Andre Ward will go down as one of the top fighters of his generation. And I don't know where Andre Ward would go even if he defeats Sergey Kovalev. I definitely don't know where he goes if he loses. He'd probably retire. But if he manages to defeat Sergey Kovalev, where does he go? Does he fight Adonis Stevenson if he wins? Does he fight Gennady Golovkin at a catchweight? Because that's a problem between them two. Like, they could never settle on a weight in which they wanted to fight, because Gennady Golovkin was saying, "I'll fight anyone between 154 and 168. And then when Andre Ward says, "Well, I'll fight you at 168, then Golovkin and his team wanted to talk about catch weights. So yeah, I really am looking forward to this fight though on June 17th. I think it's probably the fight of the summer. This is a very hot topic in boxing between Andre Ward and Sergey Kovalev. So many people with different opinions, and hopefully it will be finally put to bed in Vegas on June 17th. So yeah, comment below in the comments.